Revelations, the woman, the Madonna, the whole thing is talking about the Madonna in Revelations, and the whole thing is her calling her a whore and a fucking riding on a fucking dragon. Like, who, like, fuck you, John. How dare you? Fucking asshole.
That's probably one of my favorite parts of the Bible is in Job, when they, like, meet, you know, presumably for, like, one of the first times, maybe, since the whole fall thing. But, like, Lucifer, like, wants to tempt Job or whatever, and he goes to God, and God is, you know, sort of like, what's up? And, like, what have you been doing all this time that I, like, banished you? And Lucifer's like, he says something along the lines of, like, roaming about the earth and in it and through it.
Snails, they're spawning.
Where?
All up on these grasses.
Whoa, yeah. Holy shit. Wait, aren't those, are they alive though? They are.
Yeah, they're alive.
Damn. That's wild. Wonder what kind of snail
is. Actually, are they alive? Yeah, I think they like, this is their jam. Jesus was the Lord of the dance, right?
Bit on me. Wasn't that Michael Flatley?
The Lordess of the dance. This is so good.
about fucking Job is that the devil, like God and the devil, were working together to make this motherfucker's life miserable.
Yeah, that is funny.
I'm gonna get some water and go
eat. Says a lot about you, God.
I think maybe
that's what the Messiah does.
Maybe she you got unpaired with the thing.
But I can't go around claiming to be the fucking Messiah. That's ridiculous. That's
fucking. Why not?
I mean, I could, but I mean, the question is, do I believe it? I'm not sure.
Yeah, claim.
That's what? I
claim what you believe. I can just.
Everybody thinks they're fucking Jesus too. It's so funny.
Your music or?
No. Okay. I guess the heart of the matter isn't trying to matter to your heart, but the words I'll say get in the way before I start. But it doesn't even matter, cause I'll stand here at your door until you open up and let me show you more. You let me take your hand and take you to the promised land. I won't lead you in the cold when seasons change. And maybe you should understand everything inside this man. Cause I promise I will love you all the way to the promised land. Does this make me wrong? Am I wrong? I know it's not what you used to. That other guy up and left you. So you locked your heart and threw away the key. Yeah. And girl, I don't blame you. Please don't you blame me too. Cause everything you know was not like me. Baby, let me take your hand, take you to the promised land. Everything inside this man. Cause I promise I will love you all the way to the promised land. Oh, 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 yeah. To the promised land. To the promised land. Oh, yeah, yeah. To the promised land. Take you to the promised land. I won't leave you in the cold when seasons change. And baby, you should understand everything inside this man. Cause I promise I will love you all the way.
Such a great playlist.
Huh? Yeah, yeah, totally.
Good.
Jesus may have had a wife. Oh, the bitch out here is fucking crazy. Just tell me when, just tell me when I'm coming to you. I didn't have insurance for a while. I had no insurance coverage at all. But... God damn it, what's the back button? Okay. I have a car ran over it the other day. I dropped it in the street and my car just like... Was you? Oh, blockers. I know. Thank you for telling me that because I never fucking knew. Well, it's like, there's multiple, if we're talking about HRT, right, there's multiple parts to the combo. So there's, like, blockers, which inhibit testosterone, there's estradiol, or, like, other forms of synthetic estrogen, and then you can also take progesterone, which is what, like, really makes your titties grow. So, bless it be.
I'm not sure if I want this. I kind of just want to wear a bra and be able to have the privilege of taking it off.
You can do that with tits, though. I mean, I guess maybe in some places you can.
Like, I like the way it looks. I did that shoot the other day, and the first thing the photographer said, asked me, was my real name.
Ew.
She's like, what's your real name? I'm like, I had to pull out my ID because I had my name legally changed. So, like, she was kind of like,
What, you changed it to qween amor?
Yeah, I did.
Yes, come on.
That's awesome.
Yeah, yeah. But it's, the fact that I have to, like, sit here and defend my gender and, like, defend my name.
For sure.
Oh, it's an odd name, okay? Not many people are going around, hey, my name is Queen, you know? Little me, as far as I know.
Let them know.
But fuck. Someone says their name is shit, you call them shit.
Well, yeah, because it's like, if that's your real name, then what does that mean? The name you go by is your fake name? Like, that's such a gross...
Define reality.
Yeah, exactly.
But I put B in my middle name, so it's there. You know, like, Billy is there, but it's... like Queen Bee.
So good. Queen Bee love.
Jump from SoCal, Hollywood to the slums. Chronic smoke, get burnt by the California sun. On the west side, east coast, where you at? Just got to New York like a net on a jet. To London, to Brazil, to Quebec. Like the whole damn world took effect. To Ferg, tell them lay back, slow down. Better represent when we come to your town. So lay back, slow down. What you represent when we come to your town, say. Get in with the business, I'ma be there in a minute. I just booked a Paris ticket, thinking Russia need a visit. I'ma run it to the limit, and me, I'ma win to Venice. LA got the people saying, la 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 la. Brooklyn saying, la 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 la. I see them saying, la, 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 la. Tell them where I'm at, from the plaque to the everything fat, got muzzled on a track. My girls all stacked. When I roll down the window, let me know where you at. Atlanta, North, South, Kekalak, Texas, Grill, Cadillacs, through Miami, then back to London, Jamaica, then France. The whole damn world took effect to fart. Tell them, lay back, slow down. What do you represent when we come to your town? Lay back, slow down. What you represent when we come to your town? Get in with the business when I come from Kansas City, hit Manila till it's Christmas, out to India. Visit Puerto Rico, it's exquisite, bring my people back to Venice. LA got the people saying, la, 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 la. Moscow saying, la, 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 la. España, la, 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 la. Kingston saying, la, 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 la. San Diego saying, la, 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 la. Shutdown saying, la, 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 la. Germany saying, la, 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 la. La Puente saying, la, 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 la. It be the every city, every state, every country you know. All around the globe. Every city, every state, every country you know. This is how it goes. Every city, every state, every country you know. You know, this is how it goes. Got the people saying, la, 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 la. Amsterdam saying, la, 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 la. Frisco saying, la, 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 la. Switzerland saying, la, 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 la. Sao Paulo saying, la, 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 la. Joburg saying, la, 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 la. Mexico saying, la, 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 la. Stockholm saying, la, 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 la. Jamaica.
You wanna kill this shit, la, 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 la. Profit, feel whatever. You like to like it, we legalizing it. Yes, you can join us now. We like to love it, eh? We like to love it. We like to love it.
Don't quite. I'm a. I can't attest to childbirth in this lifetime, I guess.
I could never be the same as some Y chromosome dick possessing warmonger. I am a lesbian separatist and I don't care. Fuck that.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Do we need makeup?
Started performing because my boyfriend left. Yeah. And I was hurting, and so I started dancing at Pulse in Orlando at their little talent
Wait,
shows.
Wait, you danced at Pulse?
Yeah.
Like before all that shit?
Before all that shit. Like
Fuck,
I lived in Orlando. That's where I started my, that's where Queen Amor was born.
Holy fuck. What did you do when you heard about the shooting?
I was in D.C., and that hit home for me hardcore. Like, I don't know any of the people that were shot. I didn't, none of my friends were there, you know, but still, like, that happened, where I started performing. Like, that happened, like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
And it blows my fucking mind.
Yeah.
And I'm not, I also thought about, where I started the beginning, and then, now my fucking legal name is Queen Amor, and I'm not really a man.
Yeah.
I noticed, the evolution and the transformation of myself, and I'm comfortable with that.
Yeah.
I don't know. Every day I learn where I am placed, or how I interact with society, but I think it's important for visibility, even if I don't truly understand who I am in its fullest aspect.
Yeah.
But just to put it in society's space, in a public space where, that portion is visible.
Yeah.
Society needs to fucking see.
Well, I think it's scary, or it can be scary in that way, because you become, a conduit for people sussing out their feelings about the world.
Mm-hmm.
Like, when I was, moving through the world as a boy and just sort of, taking it for granted that, I'm a faggot, this is, the limit of the possibility of my body, and this is what I am, so I'm just gonna be good at it and, try and get laid a lot, you know? It's, moving through the world like that, we're trained not to look at each other, mm-hmm. So it's, you pass people, and it's just, like wall, you know, there's nothing there, it's transactional at best. And then like as soon as I started presenting more femme and just like growing my hair out and like, I mean, I think the hormones are part of it, but obviously like those take a while to actually show. Like now it's crazy, I can't really like hide the fact that I'm on hormones just because like my body has actually changed enough. But like people start looking, like I pass people on the street and they're just, they will openly stare from the moment they see you until at least when they pass you if they don't look back. And it's just like, they're just like trying to figure it out. Like, what's going on here? And it's not, I don't even think it's necessarily like, is it a boy or a girl? But like, there's all these demarcations that go into it. Because it's like, I'll dress up not only to be like, I'm a woman, but also like, it's a class thing. If you look rich, people are less likely to hurt you because they think they can't fuck with you. Like, in the same way that like, obviously like white girls have like, been the justification for violence rather than the target of it, historically speaking. But it's like there's also like all the demarcations. It's like if people think you have power or privilege, they won't assault you as much. And so it's like all of those are like I see it going through people's minds when they pass me, and they're just like, it's not always rage. A lot of the times it's like
utter confusion, you know? And like they have no fucking idea how to react or how to even like incorporate like. Like, I was on the bus the other day, and this, like, just sitting there, and this guy comes up, and he's like, are you wearing glitter? Like, and I'm like, like, you're all up in my face right now.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
are you brown? Are you an American? Like, what are you doing? Like, why do you care? Like, I don't understand, like, why people give a shit, like, what's between my legs or what's growing on my chest. Like, I don't understand why it's such a fucking thing.
Yeah.
And I feel like being... like identifying as trans, queer, like that's powerful in itself because it changes, like there's this new breed of person that doesn't fit this binary thing that we have all been taught to, like animals don't have gender, they don't, like it's not, like it's all a product of ego, like it's all a product of ego, and it's not like a displaying things as man and woman, and I don't have the fucking answers to shit.
Isn't that interesting how that relates back to what we were talking about earlier too with the Bible, and you know where women do feature in the Bible? It's like the gender is used as a way to limit what is possible for a person to be, based on these certain factors. Like, you ready?
So, yeah.
Hi.
Okay. Go ahead and start it, Qween.
Hi. my love is like the wind and wild is the wind. Give me more than one caress. Satisfy this hungriness. Let the wind blow through your heart for
Kind of like worm my way through different, you know, like,
yeah.
I can switch, like, I can be this, you know, where, you know, it's better, like, safer, like, it's safer for me to sex work as a boy than it is for me to sex work as a trans girl.
Yeah. I think knowing that and really coming to terms with what it meant was what has made me, like, want to chop mine the fuck off.
Do you still have yours?
Yeah. But it's like, I think that one of the reasons, like, pursuing this as aggressively as I have has really helped me get out of my head is that, like, I was already, in a lot of ways, having these thoughts around gender and power and just sort of, like, ways of moving through the world and society. But, like, you can only think about them and theorize about them and make art about them so much before it becomes this sort of, like, empty thought experiment that doesn't go anywhere. And so, eventually, I got to a point where, like, so much of my being was invested in that so strongly that, like, me that inhabited my body didn't exist anymore. I was living in this world in my mind that had no basis in the physical. And so it was like, in order to not just like peace out of this world entirely, I got to the point where it just made sense to try and like become it.
To
be in my body in the way that I was considering moving through the world or like attacking society basically as it existed before me. That's, I mean, like, that, I don't know, that sounds like a huge thing, but it's like that was what it was about for me, was like taking on the things that were bullshit and just sort of being like, well, this is why that binary or that power structure makes no sense,
and
because it literally, like, it has no, it can be blown over by an actual thing in the world.
Like, and it exists, and it's real, and it's here, and,
yeah.
You know, and we need to create an open space, like, open space for us to exist.
Yeah.
Like, at the end of the day, I don't want to have to justify my existence to anybody.
Yeah.
Like, I just want to be, you know, I just want to fucking live my life.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, like, also, so much of the patriarchy is around that, too. It's, like, it's about turning people, but especially, like, women, into ideas or, like, concepts.
At the end of the day, I was telling myself this the other day, that being a man is really just an idea. It's an idea of what people with penises are supposed to behave and act like and present themselves in order to be accepted by society.
Yeah.
And if we just let go of these ideas of who we're supposed to be and just be who we are as we are and allow ourselves room to grow and change, you know,
I mean, I hope I don't ever, like, I don't think I would ever be 40 years old and, you know, regret my choices.
Yeah, for sure.
I don't see that happening.
People keep telling me I'm going to.
That's a fear. That's why I haven't, sure. like, I haven't, like, taken, a, like, why I haven't, like, I don't know, like, how does taking estrogen, like, does it change, it changes
everything.
Everything.
I mean, it did for me, I don't know, but in, like, all the best of ways.
I don't know. You could take just blockers by itself.
Oh, yeah. You can take any drugs you want.
Pro drugs.
But, yeah, no, I was on blockers for a good 6 years before I started taking estrogen.
How old are you now?
31. I was on it, and then I went to the doctor one day, and, you know, thank God I was in New York. I went to fucking Cal and Lord and was just, like, I told my doctor at the time, you know, I want a prescription for estradiol. That was literally what I said. I wasn't like, I'm trans, I'm a woman, help me affirm my real self. Yeah. It was like, I want drugs, give me drugs. She was like, okay, why? Like, what's... Like, she said yes first, and then was like, what, you know, what's behind it? I was like, oh, she's like, I need to... I'm thinking about it a lot lately. I've always sort of, like, swung more femme. I really want to, like, figure this out. I think there's something there. I didn't even really know how to talk about it yet, I don't think. I think if I had, like, told her what was actually on my mind, I would have sounded totally crazy. I would probably still sound totally crazy. But, like, I think if anything, that's what pushes me to, like, make, like, any kind of creative work, music, performance, anything. It's, like, building a world within which people can understand the context that, like, we actually exist in. That's, like, not a thing that sounds like... like madness. Not that, like, there's anything wrong with madness, but I think it means a different thing in society than it used to. And I spent, like, my childhood and adolescence in mental hospitals and institutions, and I don't really want to go back there. So I have to, like, find other ways to express what is considered madness in the world in ways that, like, people don't react violently to.
It's fucking crazy. Like, it's crazy how, like expressing yourself in, like, a, you know, a significant art form, like, whether it's dance or form or, like, whatever it is, like, people look at you like you're fucking crazy.
Yeah.
Like, I'm fucking doing it on the streets, and people, like, they don't know how to fucking act. And I'm like, well, like, why can't I do this here? Like, why can't I, like, exist in this space? Why can't I occupy this space and dance and shake my hands?
Yeah.
You know, why I'm not my penis. Like, why is that the first thing?
Yeah.
People look at you and, like, it's the first thing they notice.
nation across the nation, a chance for folks to meet. Well, laughing and singing and music swinging and dancing in the street. Philadelphia, PA,
dancing in the street.
Baltimore, Michigan,
dancing in the street.
Don't forget the Motor City,
dancing in the street.
In the streets of Brazil,
dancing in the street.
Back in the USSR,
kill my
wow.
husband, will do.
Damien Hirst fucking bullshit.
You know, hemp.
People love to scandalize it. That's what always kills me.
This is what I'm saying. Okay, so people don't think about the way we do things, right? So every time something comes out that people think is awful, there's a whole news cycle that all of these people are making money off of producing.
I know, I play into that.
That also
I'm like, this sucks.
Gets the person
Fuck
who's
this.
Being covered as awful paid. Like, all these people make money off of scandal when really all most people wanted was for the shit to go away. But that's like, I mean, I don't know, everybody, I guess everybody feeds off of being scandalized, and on some level we all love it or something.
We also all feel like we have to react.
Of course, you know, the obligation.
It's like you're positioning yourself. Showing everyone, hey.
But again, if people thought about how their actions actually move in the world, I think we would realize that, like, indignation in and of itself does nothing. Like, your obligation is not to be indignant. If you feel like something is an injustice, your obligation is to find a way to change the environment such that that thing is no longer causing the injustice that you're experiencing.
Hey, do you have my iPod, or am I just tripping?
I have
your oh, no, I have it.
Charger.
I got it. Multitasking.
Everybody peeing and no one on peeing is wrong.
I'm like, no, I'm not doing this. You're projecting these weird ideas on my body.
Men have also been taught to, like, overestimate their dicks.
Yeah.
Like, everyone calls it dicks.
I'm like, were you measuring from your butthole?
I don't see what's the fucking big deal.
I don't either, and I honestly rejoice every time I hook up with someone with a smaller dick, because I'm like, you can actually fuck me.
For hours, right?
Yeah.
And, like, I don't
and I'm
care.
Not, like, fucked up and get hemorrhoids.
Like, I'm not fucking bleeding for an hour.
A small dick is, like, a little miracle to me.
I mean, I feel like I also care about, like, other...
Yeah, that was so disappointing.
Folks in the world, or, like, meet all the people.
Totally.
I, like, really wanted to have,
listen
like,
to all the songs. But depending on how you experience yourself, you know, like, if you experience yourself as part of the absolute truth, then you can have it all. You just have to follow this one.
You can't have it all. Nothing is an answer. God.
Fucking men. Fucking men. They're the worst. They're the worst. Ugh. Now I think I got him by the balls now. fuckers.